Okay, another most important part of biology practicals is dissections. So now we are going to start with the dissection of a mammal, and the mammal that I have before me is guinea pigs. These are two guinea pigs. So dissection of a mammal is quite common and it's very frequent, and it most often always comes in one of the groups, either group 1, 2, or group 3, group 4. So you don't know where you can belong. It's good to do all. So first of all, we will hold an organism which is about to be dissected. We have to kill it. So these ones were killed using chloroform. So chloroform was dropped and they were closed inside, so it suffocated and they died. An alternative method of killing is to use your hand to hit it at the occiput, and then the organism will just simply die. So now, in observing the external parts of this organism, first you hold the organism with your left hand as I'm holding it now, and then you touch the parts, give the name and give the function. I'll start from the head region. This is the head, this is the trunk, or what we call the body. So from the head region, I can see the mouth here with the two pointing incisors right up there, which I used to cut the leaves for chewing. So I can also see the whiskers, these long hairs that grew on the mouth. These are what we call the whiskers. So they are for sensitivity. Often, if you see this organism feeding, you find it turning the whiskers around like that. So they detect the smell from the kind of grasses they eat, so that they wouldn't eat poisonous grasses. Then you have the mouth, which is used for feeding. You have the nostrils, the two nostrils up here, which are used for breathing, just like the one in humans. So they take in air when during inspiration and send out air during expiration. They are used for breathing. Then you have the eyes. You have the eye here. There are two eyes. You have the eyes. And you notice that the eyes have the eyelid. So this eyelid functions just like the one in humans. They close the eye when there is something approaching, and they open when there is nothing. So they function for mechanical protection, or protection against mechanical injury. And they also clean the eye in case some dirt enters the eye. So it has the lacrimal glands, or what we call the tear glands, above the eyes that secretes the fluid which wipes the eye periodically as the animal moves. Then you have the ears. These are the pinnate and external ear here. This is the pinnate, external ears. And you see that these external ears have contours inside. So these contours help to direct the light waves, the sound waves, so that they will go directly into the inner ear, so that the organism can perceive. So you see that the organism is completely covered with fur. This is hair, which is used for insulation. Then you see that it has the four limbs, and the four limbs end with four digits. So these digits also end with claws, so you can have the pointed claws there. So it can use these claws to scratch the ground or even to grip the ground when it is moving. Then it has the hind limbs, which are more muscular, so it can skip or run and jump places using the hind limbs, and that's why they are muscular. Then it has teeth. You can see this thing, what is synonymous to the breast in humans. We call it the teeth, T-I-T-S. We don't call it breast, these are teeth. So it has the two teeth on the side, just like in humans. Even a male also has the breast, the female also have the mammary glands, which are well developed. But in the male, they are not well developed. So it's the same thing with the guinea pigs, since they all belong to the same class, mammalia. Then we need to determine the sex of this guinea pig. And to determine the sex of the guinea pig is what we call sexing the guinea pigs. So how do we determine? We hold it down at the anal region, and then we press it down here, and if it is a male guinea pig and we press this way, you see that the penis will come out. So you see the penis coming out here. So this penis coming out indicates to us that this is a male guinea pig. So we are pressing to push out the penis, because without pushing it out, you will not know the difference between the male and the female, because at times the testes of the guinea pig are inside. They are withdrawn and they are inside. They do not hang out like in humans, where they hang in the scrotal sac. But at certain times, you can find the testes of the guinea pig outside, and from that, you will determine that it is a male guinea pig. So this is the anus, and the anus function in the elimination of feces. You can see some pellets of feces there. It could be pulled out. And then the function of the penis is for urination. It urinates using the penis, and also functions in deposition of sperm into the vagina of the female, that is during copulation. Then we also determine the sex of this other guinea pig, which we have here. Here now you can see that the teeth here are well developed. You can see them well developed, and you can see that they are more developed than of this one. So if I come down here now to press on the anal region, I press it here, I press, you see that nothing comes out. So you see that if nothing comes out like the penis, then from here you determine that this is a female guinea pig. So you see that obviously this one here, this kind of slit which is opening as a straight line, is the vagina, and then behind here you have the anus. So you have the vagina here and you have the anus. So the anus functions just like in the male to eliminate feces, and the vagina functions for urination and also for the reception of the penis during ejaculation, so that the spermatozoa are deposited. So we may not be able to see the urinary orifice with our naked eyes, but if you use a hand lens and you open it and stretch it, you can see a tiny opening. You can see a tiny opening here, right here like that. This one here is the urinary orifice. So this means that in the guinea pig, the anal region has three openings. The opening that sends out urine, the opening of the vagina, and the opening which is the anus for sending out feces. So after observing the external parts, a candidate will be required to place the guinea pig in front of him or her, and then to draw the side view of that guinea pig, to draw and label. So if you were asked to annotate the diagram, the guinea pig that you have drawn, then it will mean that you place it, you draw it as you are seeing it, and then when you give the function, you describe briefly that part. When you name the part, you describe briefly that part, and you state just one or two functions there in brackets. You don't draw the organism and go down and take paragraphs and begin to give functions. It will be marked wrong. So for annotations, you write the brief description and then you give the function alongside to it. For example, if I label this one as external ear or penis, this is the label, external ear, or I label it as penis. So what do I give as a description? I'll say that it is a fleshy structure. You see that it is fleshy. It is a fleshy flap of tissue which is contorted inside. A fleshy flap of tissue contorted inside to direct sound waves into the inner ear. So the description is that it is a fleshy flap of tissue contorted inside. That's the description. And the function is that it directs sound waves into the inner ear. So even in our ears, if you put your hand in your ear, you realize that there are some contours inside. So the contours inside are to direct the sound waves so that they will get into the inner ear so that you can then perceive that sound. So after observing the external parts of the guinea pig, we'll go straight into dissecting the guinea pig. So we are going to do these two dissections at the same time. They will be doing one, I will be doing the other, but I will give instructions of how it should be done. So the first thing, give that hammer. The first thing is pinning the guinea pig. So you have your dissecting board with you, and you have the dissecting set in front of you. So you remove the most important.